So we have seen that when computing the ILP, we completely ignore false dependencies among data dependencies and only consider true or flow or read after write data dependencies. So ILP really only looks at those data dependencies, but there are two other types of dependencies in addition to data dependencies. There are structural dependencies and control dependencies. How do they affect ILP? And the answer is that, first of all, when looking at ILP, there are no structural dependencies. Structural dependencies occur when we don't have enough hardware to do things in the same cycle. When computing the ILP, we are assuming ideal hardware, and as part of being ideal, it has no structural dependencies, meaning any instruction that could possibly execute in the same cycle will execute in that cycle and not have to wait on some resource, like, for example, there being only one adder, so we can do only one add in a cycle. We can assume that we have an infinite number of adders, so if we want to do an add, we do it. For control dependencies, we assume that we have perfect same cycle branch prediction, meaning that branches are predicted in the same cycle in which we fetch them, so we see all the correct instructions after the branch in the same cycle in which we see a branch. Let's see an example of this, where we have a program that has a flow dependence and also an output dependence, and then we have a branch that has a flow dependence on R1 and branches to label if the condition is satisfied, otherwise continues on. And then after the branch in the program, we have an instruction, and at the label, we have another instruction. So now let's see how we compute ILP here, and these are again cycles. So what happens is in the first cycle, we can definitely do this. We cannot do the mul in the first cycle because it depends on the add. So we will have to wait until the second cycle to do it. The branch can actually not be done until the third cycle because that's where we compare this. Now let's say that this branch is actually taken. What we can assume is that although the branch cannot execute until the third cycle, from the beginning, since we started fetching the program, we knew what the branch is going to do. So we knew that the branch is going to go to the label, and thus this instruction, because it has no data dependencies on any other instruction, will actually execute in the first cycle, although it has a control dependence. So as you can see, not only are control dependencies not resulting in any delays after the branch happens, actually, we are assuming perfect branch prediction, and that means that this branch is predicted even before it's executed so that we can just do dependent instructions. Pretty much, we can completely ignore control dependencies. The branch acts as an instruction that simply produces no results, so it eventually has to execute, but it has really no impact as far as delaying other instructions is concerned. So in this case, not only does the multiply instruction execute even before the branch on which it has a control dependence executes, also the instructions that this mul will feed values to can execute before the branch. So pretty much a branch itself might be delayed because of true dependencies, but its control dependencies on that branch have absolutely no impact on what the ILP will be, because we are assuming perfect branch prediction where all the branches in the program are perfectly predicted in the same cycle as soon as we begin fetching the program. And from the beginning of the program, we knew exactly which instructions will execute so that we can just do them according to data dependencies.